7:08 now. In just over a month, California drivers will no longer be allowed to talk on their cell phones on the road without a hands-free device.
So, do you buy a Bluetooth, or is it better to install something directly into your car? KCRA3's Brian Hickey's live in Sacramento with more on the options. Good morning.
Well, basically, what that law means is you can't hold the phone to your head anymore. You can still talk on the phone with a hands-free device. And also, it means for kids under 18, you can't talk on the phone, period, in the car. Hands-free device or not, you can't talk on the phone. So here are some options. We've got Motorola here today to show us what they've got. And Ed Stalen from Motorola. First thing is you've got one of these chic earbud things.
Yes, this is the Motorola H12. So this is sort of your, if you will, entry-level hands-free option for the vehicle.
I guess the advantage of that is you can take it with you in or out of the car.
Absolutely, absolutely. But when you want something that's always in the car, ready for you to go, we have our portable car kit, and then we also have our installed car kit, the T605.
Okay, so a lot of cars, a lot of newer cars nowadays come with the Bluetooth built in.
Yep.
But this system, you can add Bluetooth to any car.
Yep.
So this device here, what does it do and what does it cost?
This is the T505. It's essentially a Bluetooth speakerphone. When you come into the car, you simply power it on. And what it does is it connects to your phone. You never have to touch your phone. You get an incoming call. You simply press a button, and you're able to hear the other party over the speakerphone.
Nice thing, too. I guess you can put it in a rental car if you're a business traveler. Take it wherever you go.
Exactly.
The other option, I guess, then, is to have one wired into the car, and that's what this one is. We'll show you this one. But first, Deirdre, we're going to call you, so get ready to answer the call here. Watch how easy this is. I've already got Deirdre's number programmed, so we're just going to hit the redial here. It muted the music.
Yep. Automatically mutes the music, so you can hear the incoming audio. You've got a microphone right here. You've got the user controls right here at your fingertips. Automatically starts when you start the car, connects to the phone, so you don't even have to think about it.
Are you going to answer my call, Deirdre?
I was screening you.
Oh, you're screening me. I wondered what was taking so long. So, Deirdre, check this out now. Your audio is coming through the speakers. Go ahead and say something profound.
Hello, Brian. How's it going?
That was deep right there. So the audio is now coming through the car speaker. Like Ed was saying, you've got this here. You know what else is cool is you can play your MP3 players through this. Talk about that a little bit.
Yeah, actually, so you have an option. If you have a phone that has the ability to play MP3 and stream it over Bluetooth, then you can actually stream your music to your car stereo as well. Alternatively, if your phone doesn't have the ability to stream music, if you have an iPod, for example, we have an adapter for an iPod that will allow it to automatically stream its music to this.
So Ed sits around all day and thinks about ideas like this. That's his job, product development, I guess.
That's correct. Product management for Motorola.
What's next? You know, what's going to be the next? I mean, this is some pretty cool stuff. You know, where do you see this going? Because obviously this is it's a convenience, but the reality is it's a safety factor. Studies have been done. Chances of getting an accident are fourfold when you're on the phone. This clearly makes things a little bit safer for drivers out there if they have to have that conversation. You know, what's next?
Well, I mean, the reality is anytime there's a distraction, it's a potential danger for the driver. And there are a lot of devices that are competing for a lot of things that are competing for the driver's attention in the car. We're trying to build solutions that basically allow the user to still stay entertained, to stay connected, to get information, but always fundamentally keeping their hands on the wheel and their eyes on the road.
And there's a lot of questions. Go ahead, Deirdre.
My question is, how do you dial the number when you're driving if you're not allowed to, be talking? Sorry, I'm hearing myself on that, too. Are you allowed to still pick up the phone and dial the number that you want to talk to?
Yes. And Deirdre, I will tell you, on our website at KCRA.com, there's a frequently asked questions from the CHP, and that was one of the questions. You can still dial, you can still text message, but clearly they strongly recommend against that. But you don't have to take your hands off the wheel to dial with this kind of a system.
That's correct. With a simple press of the button, it'll initiate the voice recognition system, which basically interprets what you say. So you can either say, call a person in my phone book. So I'd say, call Beth, my wife, for example, and it would initiate that call automatically, and I never have to pick up the phone.
Very good. Well, there you have it. Some options from Motorola, but again, a lot of other companies out there. And as July 1st gets closer, we're going to take a look at some of the other options. Log on to our website at KCRA.com. You'll find the frequently asked questions about these new laws that go into effect July 1st, no grace period. And we also set up a link to other states that have these laws. If you're traveling this summer, you're going to want to know where you can and cannot be holding that phone to your head. Deirdre, back to you.
All right, we'll see you later. You got anything else to say to Brian?
I don't have anything.
Okay, we'll see you. Bye.
Thank you, sir. 7:12 now. It is, and I can't believe you can still text.
Yeah, that just doesn't seem like a good idea.
We do all those stories about how it's equally as dangerous.
It is funny, though, because anywhere you go, if you're stopped in traffic, if you look around at the intersection, everybody's on the phone.
I'm guilty of it.
Oh, I am, too.
Constantly.
Absolutely.
On the phone.